six qualities of Dhamma. Svakkhato Bhagavata Dhammo. Svakkhato. It must be very clearly explained. No mysticism involved. No acrobatic intellectual exercises. Nothing doing. So simple. In so simple words it must be explained so that ordinary person can understand it, because one has to follow it. Unless people understand. This is not the game of philosophers or scholars. This is something which people should understand and follow. That is why the first quality of Dhamma, Svakkhato, Svakkhato, Sandithiko. Then, whatever you are experiencing with your direct experience, the truth that you experience, then it is Dhamma. The truth experienced by an enlightened person is not truth for you. The truth as explained in the scriptures is no truth for you. The truth experienced by your teacher is no truth for you. What you experience, sandhittiko, with your own eyes, with your own experience, direct experience, step by step, step by step, you may start with very gross truth, doesn't matter. This is your truth, your own experience, your own wisdom, and you keep on walking on the path with the truth, you are bound to experience subtler, subtler, subtler. The entire field of mind and matter, you experience the truth of mind and matter, and then transcend and experience something which is beyond mind and matter. Svakkhato Bhagavata Dhammo Sandhittiko Akaliko Akaliko. To get the fruits of your practice of Dhamma should not take time. Not that you practice Dhamma now and you will get benefit after death. You perform this rite, this ritual, this ceremony, and after that you will get this seventh heaven or eleventh heaven. Who has come from seventh heaven to tell me that I have performed these rites and that's why I am in this seventh heaven? All purposeless. What you gain now? Of course, after death also you will get benefit. But what benefit you are getting now? If you are getting no benefit now, then it is no Dhamma. You have taken steps on Dhamma. You must get benefit of your having taken steps on Dhamma. Then only it is pure Dhamma, otherwise no Dhamma. Somebody gives me a post-dated check. Post-dated check on a bank above the clouds, which does not exist. What am I to do with this post-dated check? One must get benefit. Akaliko. There should not be a gap between my action and the fruit that I get. Akaliko. If you really started taking steps on the path, a change must start here and now, in this very life. A change for better. Ehi pasiko. Another very important quality of Dhamma, which literal meaning is, come and see yourself. Come and examine yourself. Come and experience yourself. Ehi pasiko. People come to courses, some on the fourth day, some on the fifth day, some on the sixth day. They start thinking, oh, it is so wonderful. My mother should do it. My father should do it. So-and-so should do it. And suddenly you realize, I am here to observe my respiration, my sensation. I will see about that later on. And again, after some time, you start thinking, oh, so-and-so, very miserable person. This person must certainly get it. This is ehi pasiko. This is the quality of Dhamma. Because you are not playing an intellectual game. You are not playing a devotional or emotional game. You are actually experiencing something. Because they meditate, they can't resist. One starts thinking, whomever one meets, oh, it is so wonderful, I have tasted, it is so good, it has helped me. You also go and try. You also go and try. This is the yardstick to measure whether one has certainly, surely tasted Dhamma or not. If one has really tasted Dhamma, one is bound to get some benefit. And when one gets benefit, one feels like sharing this benefit with others. If someone is a good writer, he feels like writing something so that more and more people know about it. People do not know. Such a technique is prevailing, is being taught. If one is an orator, he will go on talking here and there. If one is comfortable money-wise, will try to spend more and more money so that more and more people come and get advantage of it. Not that you want to enlarge in your sect. Now the small sect, let there be Vipassana sect, a bigger Vipassana sect. No, nothing doing. More and more people are miserable. If they come in contact with Dhamma, if they come in contact with this technique, they will come out of their misery. And then someone feels, well, when I went to a course, all the facilities were given to me because somebody has donated. Not only that, so many people selflessly were serving me. That's why I could meditate so peacefully, so comfortably. Oh, I must also give 10 days of my life. I must go and serve in one of the courses. And people come like this to give their service. Ehi pasiko, more and more people can get benefit of it. Opaneiko. If it is pure Dhamma, then every step that you take on the path takes you nearer and nearer to the final goal. Because the path is such, so clear, like a highway. The autobahn, no curves here and there. Not that you enter it blindly and then come back. Nothing doing. Every step takes you to the final goal. And that is Oppaneiku. Adime Kalyanakari, Madhyame Kalyanakari, Antame Kalyanakari. It is beneficial in the beginning, beneficial in the middle, beneficial in the end. You practice only Shila and you find you start getting benefits. You practice Samadhi, more benefits. You practice Panya, much more benefits. You reach the final goal. Countless benefits you get. Every step that you take on the path gives result, good result. Not a single step, not a little effort that you make on the path of Dhamma goes waste. Nothing goes waste. And in this way it is called Oppaneiko. Pachattam veditabbo vinyuhiti. Pachattam, direct experience by everyone. When we belong to this sect or that sect, this community or that community, makes no difference. Dhamma is for all. Everyone can get benefit of Dhamma by practicing oneself. It is not that first you get converted in this particular organized religion, then this particular organized religion will start helping you. Nothing doing. Then there is something wrong. One may keep on calling oneself a Hindu, a Christian, a Jew, a Muslim, a Buddhist, makes no difference. Human being is human being. Out of ignorance, one keeps on generating craving, aversion, ignorance, and because of that one remains so very much agitated, so very much miserable. The path is there to take out the misery by taking out the impurities of the mind. So anyone can practice and will get the same result. Pachattam veditabbo. It must be direct experience. If you play intellectual game, it doesn't work. The same teaching was there. The entire spectrum of the spirituality of India before Buddha, at the time of Buddha and after Buddha remains the same. Come out of craving, come out of aversion, come out of illusion, delusion, nothing new. Nothing new, but still so much new, because that is all at the intellectual level, at the emotional level. Here arose somebody who says at the actual level. How to come out of craving? Well, look, you observe your sensation. Your craving starts because of a pleasant sensation. Come out of aversion. Look at your sensation. Observe it. Whenever there is an unpleasant sensation, then only you start aversion. Really? At the practical level somebody is teaching, and this is Pachattam Veditabbo. At the level of Vedana, one has to understand the reality and come out of the misery. Vinyuhi. Any wise person can do this, can practice this. It is applicable to one and all. These are the qualities of Dhamma. Understanding these qualities, if one starts walking on the path, the benefit is bound to be there.